Hi guys, my name is Matthias from TuneTrack and I'm the head of sound design. I'm going to show you a new exciting product that we have coming out. It's called Ezmix and it's really one plugin and for all kinds of instruments, and it contains a bunch of effects such as EQs and compressors and distortion, delays, reverbs, and all of that is packaged in a small plugin and only with presets. I'm going to show you so it's easier. So for example, this is a bass drum track in Pro Tools. I'm just going to go into the insert of that and select the Ezmix plugin. And there you go. So first of all, I can just scroll down and see the names of the presets and that way choose one. Or I can just print here, like kick for example. And immediately I will see all the presets that has some sort of kick relation. And I choose one preset and just start playing. And as you can see, when I scroll through presets, the sound will be very different. Let's go to a vocal track. So I'll put in a stereo. I can do go from mono to stereo because I might want to have some delays and stuff on that. So I go from Ezmix mono to stereo plugin. I search for vocal. And you will see all the vocal stuff here. And let's just choose one. And
faster! I will speed to ashes.
So depending what I do here with the blend and shape, it will change the sound. So for in this example, I will the shape will set the limiter threshold for a limiter.
Faster.
And the blend will put in more of the tape delay and the whole reverb.
Faster. I will speed.
Some more vocals.
Faster. I will speed to ashes to get into your love. Now before I slow down.
So very easy. I mean, we can do some other examples. Let's go to a bass. Let's go once again into Ezmix and do a search for bass and just scroll through. So you have two controls for shaping the sounds, and then you have one control for level if for some reason the output would be too loud, which you would see in your host, I mean, because you have lead meters and stuff like that. Let's go to a snare drum, for example, and I just choose a snare. Okay. Let's say that's what we want. And then below that, I can put in another Ezmix where I search for reverb, for example. And I choose some sort of reverb here, like a hole. Then the blend will act like a wet-dry signal in this case. So I can either use it as an insert on an effect return track, or I can use it directly on the track, and the shape will set the reverb time. You know, so it's very, very easy, and that's what, you know, the name Ezmix stands for. So it's supposed to be easy, and for the people that really don't have time to go in and learn all these EQs and compressors, what they do, this is really just to have a good sound going for them in an instant. So I hope you like it.